Did you know you can eat your landscape? It's true. We're about to show you some of those weeds you find so annoying. Dandelions, we've got plenty of those around here. And those flowers you find so beautiful, they're also quite tasty if you know which ones to pick. And joining us now to help us with that is Jim Long, who's the author of the Down to Earth column for the Herb Companion magazine, a number of books about the many plants in your landscape that are edible. And we're going to tell you where you can see Jim in person tomorrow in just a minute. But first, let's get to the point here that there's a lot of stuff in our yard, like dandelions, we think is a nuisance, but you're saying it can be a meal.
Absolutely. There's a lot of things that are on the side of the weed and feed package that are called noxious weeds, and they're not noxious weeds. They are actually nice edible plants. Dandelions. Actually, you can make a quiche out of this. You can make wine out of this.
Okay.
You can put the flowers in salads. There's all kinds of things you can do with dandelion, chickweed, henbit, all those things that you try to poison in your lawn.
And some of the blooming plants in our yard, like a hibiscus here, what could you do with that?
Hibiscus, you can turn it into tea or sorbet, either one.
Really?
Yes.
Fascinating. And daylilies, tulips. What about tulips? We have a tulip here. What can you do with that?
Well, tulips, if you're going to eat a tulip, you take out the pistil and the stamen. That's
okay,
the center
right,
part, which is a little bitter. You have this, fill it with chicken salad.
Oh, really?
Or pull the petals and put it in a salad. Works very well. They're tasty. They're good. Any color. The purple flowers are actually better than the red ones are.
According to the color, so is that because it's darker? Or?
Well, there just seems to be a more intense fragrance, and anything that has more fragrance has more flavor, usually.
And now, it even says here that you can make some sorbets from lilacs, and I want to ask you about this violet jam. Oh, go ahead. I'll have to try some.
You have to have one.
They're actually we get to that
kind
violet
of nice.
Jam. This was growing right out front, by the way.
Yes, I picked it out in front of your
We waited until the receptionist who planted them left. So. It's very good.
Yeah.
Okay, so this violet jam, we have a series of photos. How do you make that, briefly?
Violet jam is really simple. It takes pectin, sugar, lemon juice, and water, and a whole bunch of violets, and you just blend them up in the blender.
Okay.
If you go to my website or my blog, you can actually find the recipe.
There it is, blended up there.
Yeah, and I'll come up tomorrow, and we'll talk about it.
Right.
At Ulbrich. But it's very simple. It goes in the freezer, and it's wonderful flavor of violets.
And you say, like, pansies can go. They're really colorful.
Pansies are really good for sorbet.
Okay.
This makes an outstanding sorbet.
Yeah, well, this is good. I am surprised. It's tastes just like leafy green or something, but better.
Yeah, it has a little fragrant flavor with it.
And what about roses? We got a beautiful picture of roses on a plate.
Roses are great.
What can you do with those?
Roses. If you go to other countries, India, for instance, Pakistan, some of those countries, they eat roses in things like ice cream and cakes and anything that we would put chocolate or vanilla or strawberry in, they put roses in.
Okay. Well, this is fascinating. We just scratched the surface here, and people can find out more tomorrow. You're going to be out at Ulbrich Gardens from 1:30 to 3 tomorrow. You see the information there. The Madison Herb Society has brought you in, and it's going to be raining tomorrow, so all those gardening folks will be able to head inside and get a taste of what your landscape tastes like, and it's not bad, I have to tell you. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you.
Very good. I found a new snack. All right.